out of control. Well, I was down there in about an hour or so with a little mouth to mouth. She was ready to go. I'm the farmer. That's my name. Have what I got. I can cool them down when they're smoldering hot. I'm the fireman. That's my name. Burn them up. Just give me a call, I'm the fireman. That's my name. They call me the fireman. That's my name. Making my rounds all over town, putting out old flame. Well, everybody'd like to have what I got. I can cool them down when they're smoldering hot. I'm the fireman. That's my name.
All right, there you go, Rossi. And Keith is officially named his station is First Responder Radio on the Dangerous Grounds Network. There you go, bub. Yeah, man. You know, and I, like I said, man, I can run the tech for you, or somebody can, you know, until you get your stuff ready to roll. You know. So that's pretty cool. We'll talk about some dates and times and stuff right now. I'll shoot you the days and times, man, that we got set. You know, Friday, Saturday, and Sundays are wide open. We don't have anything set because it's fucking weekends, man. People are out and about doing their shit. But we'll talk about it later.
God damn.
You hit me up when you get out of work there, bro. Oh, shit.
I'm trying to get my chicken out of the bag.
Hey, maybe that chicken didn't want to come out the bag. Chicken said, fuck you. Not happening today.
Get in my belly.
Get in my belly.
No shit. Ron, give me a comedian.
Play the fuck you thing, or the fuck thing again.
The fuck you thing again.
Here you go, get people burnt out on that shit next.
I'm kidding.
Yeah, that's one. Oh, I had to go back in the damn chat group and pull it up. That's one that didn't play on YouTube. It came right off Facebook. Winner chicken dinner.
Oh, you can find it on YouTube.
Right.
I put my mayonnaise on my chicken biscuit. Dry as fuck.
Oh, fucking nasty.
Really?
God.
All right, Ron, I got you, bub. All right, here comes some Raul Sanchez.
Oh, shit.
I was in the Army for 4 years, and yeah, I know nobody believes me when I say it. Every time. Shut up. You're going to say nothing? No, it's true, but most of the time when I say it, people just kind of stay quiet. Because they don't, but they see me because I'm a little dude, and they're like, what? He didn't even have shoulders. Like, don't they issue you shoulders in the Army? Like, that's true, man. I was airborne infantry. I used to jump out of airplanes, yeah. Scary fucking thing. Scariest shit ever, man. Because I'm a little dude. Every time I jumped out, it took me like 3 times longer than everybody to get to the fucking ground. Like, at one point, a parachute was beneath me. I was like, what the fuck? Parachute is using me to lower itself safely. Man, But it was true, man. I always had to deal with that shit, being a small dude in the army, you know? Like, we used to do this thing called the buddy carry, right? And what the buddy carry is, it's an exercise where what you do is you carry your buddy, right? And then when you get tired, you put him down, and then he carries you, right? You do this for a couple of miles until the exercise is over, right? But what I used to do is I used to always pair up with my friend McGinley, right? Because we were kind of the same size. And one day, the platoon sergeant caught a hold of what we were doing, and he got really angry. He goes, "Hey, you two motherfuckers, come here! What the fuck are you doing?" And I go, "Oh, we're doing the buddy carry, sergeant." He goes, "Yeah, why you two motherfuckers always getting together when we do the buddy carry?" And I go, "Because we're the same size, sergeant." He goes, "Yeah, is that what you think? You think when you're out there in the shit, somebody gets hit, it's always going to be somebody the same size as you?" And I go, "I don't know." He goes, "Rabidoo, come here!" Now, Rabidoo was our machine gunner, this big fucking monster of a man. And he brings him over and goes, "Now what happens if you, McGinley, and Rabidoo are out there in the shit and Rabidoo's the one that gets hit? What are you going to do then?" I go, "Well, sergeant, you know, I do what I have to do. You know, I would man up and I shoot McGinley in the leg. And, hey, somebody's going to get Rabidoo! You know, I gotta get McGinley out of here! He's my best friend! Let somebody get him! That's why I always practice with McGinley. Because I know when shit goes down, McGinley's getting shot. He got so mad at me, he made me carry Rabidoo for the rest of the exercise, which looked fucking ridiculous because of how big he was and how little I was, you know? Like, every time I carried him, it looked like an ant carrying a big piece of Dorito. Because Rabidoo's body was 230 pounds of man. And my body was 130 pounds of middle school lesbian. Like, not even the type of lesbian body that would be like, "I don't see why coach won't let us females play football." It was more of the, "I think I like girls." But he was right, though. And I'll tell you this story before I get out of here, man. He was right, because we went to Iraq one time, and we got in a firefight, right? We got in a gunfight, right? And what happened was we pushed the enemy up against the Euphrates River, right? But we were in a palm grove, so there was a lot of palm trees, a lot of brush, and we couldn't really see anything. And we're ducked down there, and the bullets are flying back and forth, right? And all of a sudden, I hear somebody calling me to throw a grenade. And they're like, "Sergeant Sanchez, throw a grenade!" As soon as he said that, I was like, "You throw a grenade. The bullets are up here. That's why we're all down here, man." And he's like, "Just throw a grenade." And I was like, "Are you sure? Because there's a lot of trees, man. That shit could bounce back and hit us." And he goes, "Just throw the fucking grenade." And I was like, "God damn it." So I grabbed the grenade, right, and I pulled the pin, and then I get up on a knee and I chuck it as hard as I can, and then I get down for the explosion, and all I hear is, and then somebody yells at me like, "Damn it, Sanchez, you threw it too far and landed in the fucking river." And I was like, "Well, don't yell at me. Like, we're on the same team. Like, don't focus on the negative shit, you know? At least now we know they're not in the fucking river, you know?" But I think the reason I threw it so hard was because I was overcompensating, you know? Because when I was in high school, I was in the baseball team for 2 days. Because that's how long it took me to find out that I threw like a bitch. So it was no surprise to me when I got to basic training and all the drill sergeants were yelling at me. They're like, "Damn it, Sanchez, why can't you throw a grenade? It's just like throwing a baseball." I was like, "I know, it's fucking difficult. Plus, it's heavy, man. It's made out of metal. I didn't know it was made out of metal." It's like, "Of course it's made out of metal. It's supposed to kill people." I was like, "Well, you can catch more flies with honey, drill sergeant." Yeah, that wouldn't that be great if that's how a grenade actually worked, right? Like, you throw a grenade, a bunch of honey goes everywhere. And it actually works, right? Like, the enemy's like, "Well, I want to keep fighting, but I'm so sticky. Yeah. My neck keeps doing the thing where it sticks to your shoulder. Yeah, I'm gonna go wash off in the river, you know." They're like, "Oh, don't go in the river. They're throwing grenades in the river. That's how they get you. It's honey grenade, river grenade. Dude, I think after a while the enemy started knowing when it was me throwing the grenade every time it landed short. Because they started doing that Little League thing. All right, everybody, bring it in. Guys, thank you so much. That's my time.
All right, a little bit of Raul Sanchez with his grenade bit. And a scream of goat.
Did you find the goat?
Oh, yeah, I got the goat on lock. I got the goat and then a black guy screaming fuck on lock. Just saying. Yeah, we got some red fox coming up here in just a minute. It's been a long time since we heard from some red fox.
Go ahead.
No, I just say it's been a while since we heard from red. Cha. Go ahead.
Oh, sorry. I just pulled up behind my job or my office, and there's a toilet just chilling outside.
Yeah, hey, get a cardboard box and it's a porter shitter for the homeless.
I got you, Keith. Oh, shit. That's fucking hilarious.
Why the fuck is there a toilet out here right now?
The plumbers have been in changing something. At least you got a shitter now. Shit.
Outside, too.
Yeah, put a box around that motherfucker. We'll come push it over for you.
I just ate.
Sad. That's right, you did. Sorry. All right, here comes I guess we got to go into our commercial block, and then we'll go into a song by Nonpoint, and we'll pick up from there. Let's hear that sexy bitch.
Welcome to the Dangerous Grounds Network. Hey guys and gals, why don't you take your dick beaters off the video games in your phone and listen to the Dangerous Grounds Network? We play whatever you want over here, baby. This is the Dangerous Grounds Network. Let's get dangerous.
You don't have to be lonely.
Veterans are
lonely.com.
This is Sam from Madison Rising, and you're listening to Dangerous Grounds Network.
Branded Warriors, Inc., the original tattoo therapy program in America. Big Country and his band of warriors will take care of all America's heroes, with one drop of ink at a time. Go to bwitattoos.org to fill out your application and send it to bwitattoos@yahoo.com. Then the power of the ink and BWI will heal your mind.
Black Rose Tattoo Shop. Veteran Rand and Branded Warriors preferred tattoo shop. BlackRoseTattoo.com. All your tattoo needs.
This is Rio of Madison Rising, and you're listening to Dangerous Ground Network. Hey, you want a freedom boner or what? Listen now.
What's up? This is AJ from Madison Rising, and you're listening to Dangerous Grounds Network. And we're going to put a little bit of freedom all up in you.
Never really wanted the everyday time. Operatic over dramatic, erase my one life left to live. Day in the life with nothing to give but my last dying breath. Never really wanted the everyday time. Operatic over dramatic, erase my one life left to live. A day in the life with nothing to give but my last dying breath. With my legs.